welcome to Chart Busters. I am Reema Tendulkar. With me, Surabhi Upadhyay. And some signs of a pullback. So the Nifty's recovered close to about 30 points from the low point. So as we speak, absolutely flat on the benchmark indices. The level to watch will be the 20-day moving average of 10,807. Thereafter, the 50-day moving average of 10,823. So therein lies some resistance for our markets. And it's good to see, Surabhi, that the broader markets are outperforming yet again. So at least some green there.
Absolutely, Reema, you said it, and I think now we can start the hourly countdown. It is finally Friday, so we don't have too many hours to go before the week goes out. And yes, there is a hint of positivity in today's trading action as well. A lot of auto stocks in top gear. Anyhow, we need to get started. Let's start off with the headlines, and then we'll keep analyzing the trends as we go forward. Here are the top stories this Friday morning. Kotak Mahindra Bank is the top loser on the Nifty. That stock under pressure after nearly 3% equity changes hands in multiple block deals. CNBC TV 18 learns that ING may have sold its stake.
Jet Airways gains in an otherwise subdued market. Report suggests key lenders, State Bank of India, PNB agreed to provide 500 crore emergency funding to the beleaguered airline, subject to other lenders in consortium not objecting. Funding will allow the airline to operate until a restructuring plan is determined.
BEML gains over 3% after the company signs a certificate of partnership with Lockheed Martin at the ongoing Aero India 2019 at Bengaluru.
Adani Enterprises in focus today. Report suggests the company is in a race to buy out 23.5% stake of South African investors in the Mumbai airport.
Ashoka Buildcon up 3% after winning an NHAI order worth nearly 1,400 crore rupees. The management tells us that they will end FY19 with 35% revenue growth.
Let's invite Ashwini Gujral for a technical check on the markets to get in some strategies. Ashwini, would you keep the long positions until the weekend?
See, in fact, you should take long positions if you haven't already. Because today's morning gap down has possibly been reversed. I think it's only the Bank Nifty which is lower. And once we get past this 10,800, I think you will see a fairly strong bout of short covering. Because yesterday and today we tried to kind of give up 10,800, but we have failed. So my sense is that 10,820 may not be all that of a big problem, and in fact today's closing could be at the highs of the day, because market breadth is strong, mid caps are strong, the large caps are looking fairly good. So my sense is that once this early morning consolidation is over, you will head higher. Plus we are hearing this farm waiver, etc., and that income scheme. I think that is also propelling the market higher. So that way, I think if we can get past the morning high, you will see fairly strong short covering. Having said that, Hero Moto is a buy with a stop of 2640, target of 2720. Britannia is a buy with a stop of 3000, target of 3150. And Escorts is a buy with a stop of 650. Target of 675.
Okay, Ashwini. On the flip side, today there is a little bit of a weakness that's back on the HDFC twins. HDFC actually for most part of this week, HDFC has been a bit of an underperformer. Any thoughts here?
See, the point here is that smaller stocks, mid-cap stocks, have done better this week. So NBFCs, etc., are doing well, but even here, HDFC Bank, once we start getting past this 10,800, 820 type of zone, I think a fresh round of short covering should take even these stocks higher.
Ashwini, any disclosures?
We have long positions on Nifty, and we would intend to carry them even post today.
Thank you very much for joining in.